black hole, and the positive energy particle will go away from the black hole. And this particle, of course, is a photon, a light wave. And so we get to see these particles effectively look like they're coming from the black hole. Now, since the black hole is absorbing the negative energy particle, that means it's losing energy. Since mass is a form of energy, it means effectively it's losing mass. And so with time, the black hole will lose mass and eventually die through what we call Hawking radiation. However, for a black hole is a few times the mass of our sun, it takes about a Google years for this to occur. So 10 to the 100th year. In fact, they will be the last objects in our universe before the death of our universe. The biggest ones, the centers of galaxies, will take about a Google to the 3 halves power. That's 1 followed by 150 zeros. So a lot longer, a little bit longer. And the ones that were going to be created by the Kern, the Hadron Collider, those would take about 10 to the minus 7 seconds to die, because they're really, really tiny. In fact, they're so small, they're much smaller than the size of a proton. In fact, a proton couldn't even get into it. It's too big. So to wrap up, we've learned about the universal nature of gravity. We've seen how gravity causes tides as well as black holes, and our one equation for gravity. All right, that's all for this lecture. But this, remember, we have a second lecture for this week on orbits, and we'll start that in just a moment. So sit tight, click the next link, have a cup of coffee. I don't know. I probably put half of you to sleep anyway. So.